Let me start my satsang. Even if I analyze the physics, chemistry and biology of the Hindu society, all of you can learn a lot of lessons. All of you can learn a lot of lessons. Physics, chemistry and biology of Hinduism and Hindu society. Gap between Hinduism and Hindu society. And who created it? Why it is being constantly maintained? Who is keeping it alive? How it is going to revive itself? All the Brahmins were denied food if they continue to keep the Vedas as their lifestyle. How much poverty you can face? There is a limit, na? I tell you, most of the Hindus are made to believe Brahmins kept Vedas secret. No! I tell you, just like sati was reaction, understand, committing suicide, sati, it was a reaction. The decision we took to save ourselves from being a sex slave, all of you understand? Burning your body and dying is the worst method of suicide. But our grandmothers have decided that so that they will not leave the DNA for the DNA thieves. Understand? You need to know the fellows who are coming to harass us. They were not just animals, demons. They used to rape dead bodies. Because even after death, you can steal the womb and pregnate it and get the children. See, they came for the purpose of DNA stealing. Even if you drink poison and die, they will steal the DNA. That is why our grandmothers, ancestors have decided to burn themselves so that the DNA stealing will not happen. Just like how sati was forced response, I tell you, Brahmins keeping the Vedas was a forced response. You don't know. I tell you. Two reasons. One, the moment Brahmins teach, the moment all their knowledge is taken, they are killed. Second, Brahmins felt, array, already I gave my life to it. Anyhow, I am going to die. If you learn, you are also going to be killed by the enemies. You do at least your Kshatriya job and Vaishya job and protect the country. It is a sacrifice. Understand? It was forced reaction. See, when the invaders came, they are basically sex-based civilization. They wanted girls from our palaces. Their whole strategy was just based on sex. They will supply prostitutes to the army fellows and get information or weaken them. They will get all our queens, princes, everyone as their sex slave. They will use our own women as a prostitutes to get information from army and spies. When it comes to attacking the great gurus and brahmanas, they just use false news about sex, that's all. Use false news related to sex to collapse the Brahmins and gurus. Just spread some rumors and scandal. Kshatriyas supply prostitutes and get information and weaken them. From palace, steal women. Understand, if the women are allowed to be stolen from the palaces, they are used to collapse the whole social system. That is the reason women decided, let us commit suicide instead of being used to collapse the whole social structure. Every woman who committed sati, I bow down to them for their sacrifice. For their sacrifice. It is not a small joke. It is not a small joke. Every Brahmana who gave his life for protecting the Vedas, I bow down to them. It is not a joke. Understand, whether sati or varna ashrama dharma or the idea Brahmins are keeping the knowledge secret, all lies dumped on us. Hey, there are tons of records where Brahmins ran the Gurukul where all the Varna studied. Every single thing every single attack we faced is a planned conspiracy. Understand? Planned conspiracy. It is a see on agriculture community, the civil conspiracies were done. Like destroy the goshalas, animal husbandries. On Kshatriyas, the criminal conspiracies were done. By putting each other against, making the Nayakars and Cholas fight, making the Pallavas and Pandyas fight, the amount of civil conspiracy and criminal conspiracies done on Hindu society how the goshalas gurukuls temples actually this three is the backbone of Hinduism temple serving meal 24 hours goshalas supplying cow based products and medicines 24 hours gurukul supplying knowledge to all this three should be there in every village that is mission of my life I am working I'll do it at least in Bangalore Adhinam first today only I gave my vision we have 5 acre compound wall if we do vertical gardening on that 5 acre compound wall within 1 year we can not only supply enough vegetables flowers fruits for the whole bidhi we can even export I am not talking about selling I am talking about donating giving food one second 5000 cows providing all cow based medicines and products freely to all the surroundings temple supplying food freely 24 hours this tree should be the brand and now we can add our unique contribution at least 5 sannyasis available in each ashram manifesting all the 463 powers and supporting the humanity in all their problems and helping them spiritually let's do at least in few places immediately and show if goshala comes back to life indian agriculture will come back to life if gurukul comes back to life indian intelligence will come back to life Temple comes back to life. India will come back to life. And if power manifestation sannyasis come back to life, we will take the whole humanity to the next level. I think this is our priority. This is our priority. This should be our priority. We have to do it. We will do it. Tomorrow we have Jeevan Mukti Jayanti, the special global third eye initiation program and the Jeevan Mukti Aushadha process. Still the book is as fresh as the day it was delivered. Still when I open the book, I don't feel something which I know now, I have not said it in that book. When I see, wow, I said this that time itself. Still, I can only write commentary on that book. I have nothing to develop on that book because all the original first line sutras I need to tell, I have already told. The book remains unparalleled gift to the humanity. So from next year, let's celebrate Jeevan Mukti Jayanti as the Brahmotsavam for 11 days. Like how Gita Mata, as a deity statue, will make a deity for Jeevan Mukti. And it should be worshipped. It should be worshipped. So with this, I request everyone to become part of the Nityananda Sangha and sign up to be connected so we can help you to manifest all the powers of Mahasadashiva and super conscious breakthrough. I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam. Mahasadashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.